six most successful European actors in Hollywood. Luck opened the doors for these European actors to penetrate the dynamic Hollywood film industry. They stayed for long beyond a one-hit wonder, thanks to their immense talent, passion, and commitment to their craft. With worldwide hits and critical acclaim tucked under their belts, they undoubtedly represent the most successful European actors to conquer Hollywood and beyond. Number 6. Jean Reno. Jean Reno is unlike many French actors who struggled making it big in Hollywood. Perhaps they can find value in Reno's advice. You have to realize that establishing yourself takes time. You are not going to waltz in and simply replace an American star. He gained fame in French films he did with director Luc Besson, like The Big Blue, La Femme Nikita, and notably, Leon, The Professional. At age 47, Reno made his Hollywood debut in the rom-com French Kiss in 1995, and it wasn't too late for him, so it seemed, for he starred in several Hollywood box office champions alongside Tom Cruise in Mission Impossible, Robert De Niro in Ronin, Matthew Broderick in Godzilla, Steve Martin in the Pink Panther remake, and Tom Hanks in The Da Vinci Code. Juggling between France and America, Reno is truly having the best of both movie worlds, literally. Number 5. Antonio Banderas. Whenever Hollywood needs a suave Latin lover character, Spanish actor Antonio Banderas is perennially at the top of casting directors' minds. He started acting in 1982, doing Spanish movies mostly with two-time Oscar-winning director Pedro Almodovar, whose 1990 controversial film Tie Me Up, Tie Me Down became the actor's breakthrough role. Pop superstar Madonna took notice of Banderas' potential and introduced him to Hollywood. They later starred together in the 1996 musical drama Evita, which earned Banderas a Golden Globe Best Actor nomination. Despite being not as fluent in English, Banderas starred in many high-profile Hollywood movies like Philadelphia, as the lover of Tom Hanks' character, Interview with the Vampire, and as Sylvester Stallone's nemesis in Assassins. The Spanish heartthrob eventually landed lead roles in Desperado, The Mask of Zorro, The 13th Warrior, and Original Sin, opposite Angelina Jolie, and Take the Lead. Bravo to one of Spain's sources of pride. Number 4. Jean-Claude Van Damme. Growing up in Brussels, Belgium, Jean-Claude Van Damme was preoccupied with martial arts that brought him victories in many competitions, and later on became his ticket to star in Hollywood martial arts action films. In 1982, JCVD moved to America hoping to land an acting job. He started out as a bit player and became part of action stars Chuck Norris's stunt team. Then Bloodsport came in 1988, which became the turning point in JCVD's career. Based on the true story of martial artist Frank Du, Bloodsport grossed $65 million worldwide against a $2.3 million budget. The movie's success landed tailor-made roles for JCVD in medium-budget movies like Cyborg, Kickboxer, and Double Impact that were profitable ventures. He was signed up by major Hollywood studios and headlined the blockbuster movies Hard Target, Universal Soldier, Time Cop, and Street Fighter, which all strengthened the muscles from Brussels' international fame. Number 3. Christoph Waltz. Christoph Waltz holds the distinction as the only Austrian-German actor to win two Oscar awards, both for the Best Supporting Actor category and Quentin Tarantino-directed masterpieces. Waltz studied acting in Vienna and New York before pursuing it. He was a prolific actor doing work mostly for German television and film production since 1980. 29 years later, Waltz got his biggest Hollywood break via Tarantino's Inglourious Basterds in 2009 in a role Tarantino described as unplayable. For his performance as a Nazi party officer, he won the 2009 Cannes Film Festival Best Actor Award while collecting Best Supporting Actor trophies from the Oscars, Golden Globes, BAFTA, and SAG Awards. The Tarantino-Waltz collaboration in 2012's Django Unchained repeated history as the actor again won Golden Globe, BAFTA, and Oscar Best Supporting Actor nods. He also appeared in more prominent Hollywood movies and showed how a late bloomer can also be a winner. Number 2. Alexander Skarsgård. At 6 feet 4 inches tall with 8-pack abs, Alexander Skarsgård was a convincing on-screen Tarzan, the only Swedish actor to portray the King of the Jungle in 2016's The Legend of Tarzan. It was his biggest film role in Hollywood and marked how far he had gone from doing an unforgettable role in 2001's Zoolander. As a kid, Skarsgård appeared in a film and TV show in Sweden, which was kinda expected for him, for his dad, Stellan, is one of Sweden's biggest stars. His Hollywood break came in 2007, when he was cast as a US Marine in HBO's miniseries, Generation Kill. His follow-up project that made him a household name was the TV series True Blood. Portraying a 1,000-year-old vampire sheriff, Skarsgård finally attained critical acclaim for his menacing performance as an abusive husband in HBO's miniseries, Big Little Lies, winning for him Golden Globe, SAG, and Primetime Emmy Awards. Number 1. Javier Bardem. After doing dozens of films in his home country, Spain, Javier Bardem did his first English-speaking role in Before Night Falls in 2000. It earned him an Oscar Best Actor nomination, the first for a Spanish actor. Even Bardem's idol, actor Al Pacino, praised his performance. It's no surprise critics and colleagues find his acting ability praiseworthy, for Bardem comes from a long line of filmmakers and actors in Spain, including his mama. His foray into mainstream Hollywood movie making started in 2004 by co-starring with Tom Cruise in Collateral, followed by more major studio releases. In 2007, Bardem cemented his acting competence when he won Best Supporting Actor in the Oscars and other major award-giving bodies for his fearsome work as a sociopathic assassin in No Country for Old Men. Again, he became the first Spanish thespian to achieve that feat, giving him the reputation as Hollywood's best Hispanic import. We're posting more interesting videos every single day, so please subscribe to our channel. Thanks for watching.